Hello again, everyone, and welcome to the Prelim Gold Cup press conference. Right now we have Trinidad and Tobago, and we are welcoming the head coach, Mr. Angus. If you have any questions for him, please raise your virtual hand and I will be more than happy to give you the floor. Manuel Medina, start, please.
Hello, coach. This is Manuel Medina from TA Sports in Mexico. I wanted to ask you, Trinidad and Tobago is one of the teams that usually it's in the final hex for the World Cup qualifications. It's also usually in the Gold Cup. Can you tell us what has changed about that in the last couple of years? And also, how do you feel about the new format to qualify to the Gold Cup tournament? Thank you.
Hi, Manuel. Well, to answer the first part of the question, we're very disappointed not to be one of the natural qualifiers as we have been in the past. Unfortunately, a lot of off-the-field issues back in our country has caused football to take a bit of a dive. And then the new format, speaking about that, I think it's good. It was a little bit different, but in the end, I think they got it right and everybody have an equal chance of getting the opportunity to go forward.
Next question, Jose Rodriguez.
Coach, can you talk a little bit about the biggest challenge that you guys have faced in the last few months, maybe separate from the pandemic, of course, and if that is, please feel free to talk about it, but what are some of the biggest challenges that you have faced in the last few months?
As I said before, you know, it's off the field stuff, administrative stuff. We had a change of administration. We were normalized by FIFA at that point in time. And it took a lot of adjusting. And I think the on the field stuff was really affected by that whole situation. So that would be the biggest challenge we had besides the pandemic.
Thank you. Next question, please. Paul Nicholson.
Hi, Angus. It's Paul Nicholson, Inside World Football. I mean, obviously the off the field stuff has been pretty devastating. You haven't really played an awful lot. The matches you have played at times have been really poor for what a nation like Trinidad and Tobago would expect. You're coming in kind of at the last minute to try and save the day. How big a task is that? Because you're up against some spicy opponents of Montserrat for sure.
Yeah. Yeah, Paul. It's a difficult task, but one that I wouldn't take the job or take the opportunity if I didn't think that we have the players. I believe in the players that we have. It's unfortunate what happened in the World Cup qualifying with the guys. I said a lot of off the field stuff really affected the team and the team's progress and the synergy of the team. But I always believe in the players, and I think that it's been a short space of time, but the enthusiasm and the refocus of the team has been brilliant so far. And we are really looking forward. And as you rightly said, you know, Montserrat is not an easy team, but we are up to the challenge, and we want to show the people of CONCACAF that we are still to be reckoned with in the region.
Thank you. Next question, Art Bell.
Yes, thank you. Hi, Coach. You know, there's some familiar names on your roster. Kevin Molino, of course, Aubrey David. Those are very familiar names in CONCACAF. But, you know, kind of give us an idea about some of the younger players that you've called. Jesse Williams, a defender, Judy Garcia, midfielder. You know, what are their qualities that are going to help your team in this game?
But they're the future. They bring enthusiasm. They bring freshness to the team because the team was a little bit down mentally coming out of a failed World Cup campaign. So these youngsters will bring that sort of energy, vitality. And I think people will be very surprised with the level of play that those guys would bring to the table. So, you know, it's just a wait and see and come tomorrow and hopefully the guys believe in themselves and apply themselves in the game.
Next question, Andre Yanis.
Good afternoon, Coach. I wanted to ask you about Montserrat. What can you expect from them tomorrow from what you have studied preparing for this game? And also, would it be nice to win tomorrow and be able to watch the game of the two teams that can be your opponent if you qualify for Tuesday? Thank you.
Yeah, we're in a great position if we can win the game tomorrow, because we can then see the opposition on the following day. So yeah, that's a good position to be in. But at the end of the day, we have a game to play against not an easy opponent. Montserrat basically has a lot of players who are playing in the English lower leagues. They're very seasoned campaigners. They're well coached, well organized. And those are the things that we expect from them. They will come and they would fight the game. If you ever played in the lower leagues in England, you'd know those are the type of qualities that they will come forward with.
Next question, Jose Rodriguez.
Coach, we were just talking just a few moments ago with Russell Latapy, a key figure for Trinidad. And I was just wondering, how far are we from seeing that type of quality player, Stern John type players that pretty much brought Trinidad to the top in CONCACAF to compete with the top teams? How far is Trinidad from that?
I don't think we're that far off, to be fair, in the sense of there'll be different characteristics of players. Those guys were really tremendous individual players. Now we have to depend more on the team concept, but we still have people like Khaleem Hyland, Kevin Molino, Jovan Jones, who do have that sort of quality. Unfortunate for them, they didn't break into the English Premier League and stuff like the other guys or the Scottish Premier. But I do think that they do have the type of talent that could take them forward. And also we have young guys, as you know, said Judah, we have Levi, who's not here. So we're still producing players at a high standard. It's just to bring it all together.
One last question, Andrea Yanis.
Coach, talking about Jovan Jones today, Phil Neville, his coach, announced that he was injured. Can you talk a little bit about that and not having him for this games? Thank you.
Well, actually, we were in the stands watching the game, and it's really unfortunate for Jovan and for Trinidad and Tobago not to have him, and I guess for Inter Miami also, because he's a tremendous player. He brings confidence to any group that he would be in. Unfortunately, we have to play for him and not with him in this tournament, because the guys are motivated. This is his stadium that we're going to play in. This is his home. So the guys are going to put out all the best to ensure that Jovan feels proud of the guys and, you know, represent him in the right way.
Thank you, Coach Eve. We will continue the press conference with Khaleem Hyland.
Thank you.
Thank you for your time.
No problem.
Hello, Mr. Hyland.
Hi.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you have any question, please raise your virtual hand. Archibald, go ahead.
Hi, Khaleem. You know, you're such an experienced player, a veteran player, a guy who has played in so many Gold Cup games. What are you telling some of these younger guys who have yet to experience a Gold Cup? What this game is going to be like tomorrow, in a type of, you know, a Gold Cup, a must win, a one off, and with a Gold Cup feel to it.
Hi. Yeah, well, I've been telling the guys, you know, and encouraging them to go out there and play with confidence, whatever, you know, we are doing in training, to have the confidence to apply it in the game, because we have a lot of talent, and I am surprised to see how much talent that a small country as Trinidad and Tobago can provide.
Next question, Andre Yanez.
Hi, can you talk a little bit about what can you expect with Montserrat? We all know what happened with you guys in the World Cup qualifiers, and how can you turn the page around and focus on Montserrat with everyone, including us, the fans, and everyone bringing the World Cup exit every time? Thank you.
Yeah, well, we are disappointed for the World Cup qualifiers that we are out. But, you know, that's life. We have to skip the page. Now, we are only as good as our next game. Our next game is tomorrow against Montserrat. We know it's going to be a tough game. We know, as the coach said, there's a lot of players from lower leagues in England and so on. And we know the quality that they can give, so we have to match it, and also we have to try to manage the game for 90 plus minutes, and hopefully we can come on victorious at the end.
Thank you. Andrianas, go ahead again.
Thank you. I wanted to ask you about Jovin Jones. I asked the coach right now, today it was announced that he would be out for a couple of months, maybe. Have you talked to him, and what did he say? What did he say about the national team and about his injury?
Yeah, well, Jovin Jones is a good friend of mine. You know, he came by on a couple of occasions to check us at the hotel and stuff. He will surely be missed, because not only he's a great player, he have a great spirit, and he's also a funny character that we need and love him when he's in camp with the national team. He always makes you laugh. He keeps you going. And, you know, we will miss him. We just wish him speedy recovery, and we have to win the game for him, as coach said.
Last question, Paul Nicholson, go ahead.
Hi, yeah, it was mentioned, coach mentioned obviously the off the field problems, and you needed to put that behind you to really start to progress again. How easy is that? Because I mean, it's a very heated atmosphere in Trinidad and Tobago. That's, you know, it's hugely important football. How easy is that to leave behind you and go out there and actually play the real game, you know, and express yourselves to the way that, yeah, to bring out that talent that you've been talking about, because it hasn't been showing in the last few games. I mean, are you feeling in a good place to be able to do that now?
Yeah, well, as we know, Rome wasn't built in a day. And when we have problems, now we are changing things around. Now we have a new start. This is a fresh environment. Now we have a new coach. We have new staff. Everything has been going smooth in the camp. Training has been great, intense. The spirit, the chemistry has been going good. And we, as I said, we are only as good as our next game. So hopefully everything can change tomorrow, and then we can come out from the hole we are in. And we are players, we are footballers, you know. We cannot study much about the politics things. We have to go out there and play. I know there's a lot of things that can break our concentration. By the end of the day, this is sport. You know, it have politics going on around the world, and we as players just had to focus on doing the job. And it's nothing better than playing football and doing the job that you love.
Thank you, Mr. Hyland. And with that, we finished the press conference.
Thank you very
much. Thank you for your time. The next press conference starts at 18:00, 6 p.m. Thank you.